Hello everyone, welcome again here in this video tutorial. This is class 4th and we are doing chapter number 4, that is solid, liquid and gas. Dear children, we are surrounded by many living and non-living things. And all these things take up space and have some weight and mass. So what is matter? Anything or substance that has mass and occupies space is called matter. Okay? So, let us understand matters with an example. Let us take a book and place it on the table. And what you notice? Yes, the book is occupy the space of a table. Okay? And if I put a book on a weighing machine, then it shows book has weight. Okay? This proves book is a matter. Okay, children? And do you know, children? Matter is made up of very tiny particles called molecules. Yes, molecules. So, here, every living or non-living things is matter, and brick is also matter. And you can see in this picture that the brick is made of many tiny particles called molecules. Understood? So next we will see states of matter. Matter can exist in three main states, physical states, depending on how the molecules are packed or arranged. These states are solid, liquid, and gas. Let us have a look on these states in detail. Solid. The first one is solid. Solids are usually hard and have fixed shape and volume, which I already told you earlier and taught you earlier. Look at the example of solids: table, chair, books, stones, etc. However, we can change the shape of some solids by using force. For example, dough can mold out into chapati. And yes, interesting shapes can be made out by clay. Okay? So then, children, the question arising is, why solids have definite shape and volume? Can you tell me? Okay, think. Okay, children, I told you earlier that only any object, either solid or gaseous, totally depends on molecules of objects. Okay? It depends how molecules are packed or arranged. So, in solid, molecules are closely packed to each other. As you can see here in this picture also, there are no space between molecules to move around. Okay? In this picture, you can see next is matter in liquid state. Liquids have definite volume but no fixed shape. A liquid takes the shape of container which is poured. In liquid, molecules are not very closely packed to each other. You can see in this picture also, there is a vapor and there is a water in it. Okay? And you can see the molecules are not very closely packed to each other. There is a space between molecules to move around. And this allows liquid to flow. So, liquids are also called as fluids. Next, matter in gaseous state is air is the gaseous state of matter. Gases have no definite shape and no volume. No definite volume. It means a gas has no shape and no size. Gas takes the shape of any container in which it is filled. So here you can see the example of gases. Now let's see how molecules are arranged in gaseous state. In gas, molecules are very loosely packed to each other. As you can see in this picture also, molecules move quickly in all directions. So look at here, gas flows more easily and rapidly than liquid. Take an example of perfume. The smell of a perfume spread quickly from one corner of the room to the next corner. Isn't it, children? So our next topic is change of states. Matter can change its form from one state to another. So it can change from solid to liquid, liquid to gas, gas to solid. Okay, so it is also called inverse direction. It changes inverse direction. So first is change of state from solid to liquid. Okay, the process by which a solid changes into a liquid is called melting. So take an example of water. When we take out an ice cube from the refrigerator and leave it in a room temperature, so what we notice? Yes, ice start to melt into water. And this process is called melting of water. Understood? Next state is changing liquid to solid. The process by which a liquid changes into a solid is called solidification. So, if you fill a water in an ice tray and keep it in the refrigerator, freezer, you can see the after some time the water start converting into ice. Okay, so freezing of water into ice is known as solidification. So next is change of state from liquid to gas. The process by which a liquid changes into gas is called vaporization. Okay, vaporization happen by boiling and evaporation. So here when we boil water in a pan and water start boiling, you will notice after some time the level of water is decreases. Okay, why this happens? Yes, this is because the water changes into steam, and this steam is called water vapor. Okay, and the same way evaporation, sun rays falls in the oceans and which makes the water hot, and water changes into water vapor. Okay children, next is gas change to liquid. The process by which gas changes into liquid is called condensation. For example, when water starts boiling and hold a cold steel plate on water boiling boiling water, you can see droplets collecting on the plate. What will happen? How it is happen? Can you tell me? Yes, water vapor changing back into the water after cooling. So children, by these examples we can easily learn change of states of matter. Okay, it's a reversible process. solid to liquid, liquid to gas, and gas to solid again. Right? Now move on to the next topic, that is solubility. Fine? Solubility, we will learn the next topic. So, what is solubility? Let's take out your notebook and write down the things. So, first of all, solubility. Solubility is the ability of one substance to fully dissolve in another substance under specified conditions. Right? Okay, one substance to dissolve another substance is known as solubility. Okay? Now come to the next point, that is solution. What is solution? Solution is a mixture of two or more components that form a homogeneous mixture. Okay, it means that same mixture. It's form a homogeneous mixture. It means homo means same. So it's form a same mixture. That is known as solution. Fine. Okay, our next point is solute. Okay, what about the solute? The substance which is dissolved is called a solute. We will take the example of these things, that is solubility, solution, solute, and solubility, solute, solution, and solvent. First of all, we will learn about this. So solute is the substance which is dissolved is called a solute. Okay, now come to the next point, that is solvent. So the substance in which the solute is dissolved called a solvent. Right? Solute plus solvent is equal to solution. Okay, so solvent is a substance in which the solute is dissolved. Right? So we have example like salt is a solute and water is a solvent. When we mix each other, so we have a new solution, salty water. Right? Okay children, let's take an example of solubility test. Here we have a glass of water in which we have poured, we have poured water and salt, and we mixed it. Okay, that makes a solution. Right? So you can see here, solute plus solvent is equal to solution. It means solute is our salt and solvent is water. When we mix together, that makes a solution. Right? So children, by this example, we have learned about the solubility and solution, solute and solvent. Right? Let's move on to the another topic. So children, the topic is physical and chemical change. And you know, there are three states of matter, solid, liquid and gas. So change of state, matter can change from one state to another on heating or cooling. And heating and cooling bring about changes in matter. Some changes are temporary while others are permanent. Basically, there are two types of changes, physical changes and chemical changes. So let's talk about first physical changes. A physical change is a temporary change which can be reversed. Right? It is a temporary change which can be reversed easily. And in physical changes, the properties are, they are temporary as from the name only physical appearance of the matter changes, not chemical. Let's have some important points of physical changes. They are only in the state of matter. So, force changes that takes place in there are temporary changes that only takes place in the state of matter, that is only its physical properties or appearance changes, like its shape, size, color, volume, etc. It can be reversed easily. Okay, children? It can be reversed easily. So, let us check out some examples of physical changes. Here we have water. When we cool water, it will become ice. Right? So, it's a physical change. And again, when we take ice and keep into a room temperature, and then if we boil the ice, heat the ice, it will become water. Reverse. Okay? When we cool water, it will become ice, and when we heat ice, it will become water. It's reversible. And when we heat water, it's convert into water vapor. And then the fourth one is, the fourth example is, when the water vapor cooling, it's convert into water. Fine. It is totally reversible. It means that its physical change is showing. Okay, now take a beaker of water. This is example of physical change. When we cool water, it's convert into solid, okay, ice. And when the ice heated, when we cool water, it become into ice. And here you can see ice. Okay, this is a solid part. Fine. And it is changes into, when we reverse it, when we take ice and we heat this ice, it will convert into water again. Okay, so look at here the reversible process. We take ice and kept into a room temperature, fine, or we heat it, then it will melt and become water. Then when we heat it again, it will convert into water. So totally the process is reversible. It means that physical changes are showing here. Okay, children? Now look at here. The first is water in the liquid state. When we cool it, it is convert into ice, solid state. And this is a solid state ice. When we heat the ice, it will convert into liquid state. Okay? Then when we heat the water, it will convert into water vapor. This is known as the gaseous state. This is known as the gaseous state. And the gaseous, in the gaseous state, when the water vapor, when we capped a lid, a cool lid in the pan, over the pan, the water vapor is showing here. So it's also known as the gaseous state. Okay. Let's take another example of a candle. Solid wax, when we heat, it will convert liquid wax, and liquid wax cooling its solid wax. So here is the candle. When we heat the candle, it will melt. Okay, it will melt. And when we cool it, this wax, this melted wax, okay, when we heat the candle, it will melt. And when we cool it again, it will convert into a solid wax. So let us learn about chemical changes. So here, in chemical changes, heating or cooling result in a permanent change in the state of matter. It is permanent in the chemical state. Okay, a new substance is formed and we cannot get back the old substance. In the chemical changes, we can get a new substance. Okay, so let's take an example of fire. Here, the log of wood is burning, and if we burn the log of a piece of paper is burnt, it changes into ash. The molecules of paper are different from the molecule of ash. You can see here, this is burning paper and this is ash. Okay, children? So, this is a chemical change. This is totally change. For other example, Let's take other example, burning of matchsticks. We cannot get matchstick back. Cooking of food and formation of curd from milk. If we form curd from milk, we cannot get back the milk again. Okay. Now let's look at the some points on chemical changes. They are permanent and they can't be reversed. Okay. And the third point is result in the formation of new substances. In the chemical changes, we always get a new substance, right? Understood, children? So let's take an example of chemical changes. We know that change the amount of matter in an object, and some new type of matter is created that looks entirely different from the original matter. So you can see the example of egg. When we fry a egg, then we get a new substance, that is omelet. Okay, it will not convert into a egg again. So it will totally change. That's why it's a chemical change. Okay, let's take another example of burning of paper. If we burn a paper, when the paper will burn, it convert into ash. We get a new substance, right? This is ash, burning of a paper. We get from it burning of a paper. So it is totally changed. We cannot get back the paper again. This change cannot be reversed. That is, ash cannot be changed back into paper again. Okay, so this is a chemical change. It's a chemical change or an irreversible change. Okay, children?